Good evening. I'm Thomas Blackwell, and I'm here tonight to present to you some dramatic film clips of racism in America. This is Racism Unchained. We're here tonight to expose some of the things that have happened to people of color, especially black people in America, during the early 1900s up until today. Tonight we're going to share a story about Hayes and Mary Turner. Hayes Turner was a young man, 19 years old, hanged because of a crime they said he committed. Because his wife, Mary Turner, complained, she was hanged the very next day. The only difference between Hayes and Mary's situation, that Mary Hayes, or Mary Turner, rather, was 7 months pregnant. The story you're going to hear tonight is gruesome and horrifying, but I pray that you will stay with us. So that's the Mary Turner story. All these stories can be verified in your history books, on YouTube, perhaps even better, because the history books didn't cover a lot of these stories. These things were deleted or never published in any type of publication. Even our newspapers during that period of time didn't cover these stories. And as today, many of the stories that are happening in the black community and brown communities don't get covered by the news media. So it's no big thing about that. But we're going to share them with you tonight on Racism Unchained on KTYM.media. Our second story will be that of Claude Neal. Claude Neal was lynched for a crime he didn't commit. He is possibly the last public lynching of this century because it was such a spectacle you won't believe. Carolyn Anderson will share that with you tonight as we talk about the history of and quest for civil rights. And this is sponsored by Emory University. So we have a lot of information for you tonight and want you to be informed and educated. The next story is about the Shubuta Bridge. We're dealing with the bridge in Mississippi called the Shubuta Bridge, where two young men, Ernest Green and Charles Lang, were hanged from that bridge because of accusation that they had assaulted a white girl. The last story is on a young man, the youngest man ever executed. His name was George Stinney. George was 14 years old, accused of assaulting a white girl. The youngest man ever executed in the United States. It's something, the movie is horrifying, but you'll see clips tonight of George Stinney. And then we have a more modern day situation with Eric Garner. Eric Garner, the familiar slogan, "I can't breathe," has been heard all over the world. Even a song has been written about that situation where a young man was put into a chokehold and the last words that he breathed or spoke, "I can't breathe." All of that for you tonight on KTYMmedia.com. Every Sunday night, we share these clips about racism in America. It's called Racism Unchained. I pray that you'll watch it tonight and tell a friend and educate our children on some of the things that have happened. It doesn't matter whether you're white or black, because these things need to be exposed to all Americans. A lot of our white Caucasians don't know anything about why they hate what people of color. Well, these will give you some examples, and it'll devastate your heart. I'm Thomas Blackwell. Stay with us as we look at our very first clip tonight.